Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. Today the topic of our discussion is a very core concept in genetics, that is the difference between homologous chromosome and non-homologous chromosome. Starting with the definition of homologous chromosomes. Homologous chromosomes are chromosomes that are having similar length, same gene position, same staining pattern and same centromeric location. Homologous chromosomes are the chromosomes that pair during meiosis. Let's begin with a karyotype. This is human karyotype. As it is XY, this is male human karyotype. So as you can see, there is 46 chromosomes, 22 pairs plus X and Y. So this is chromosome number 1, this is chromosome number 2, this is chromosome number 3. As you can see, as we are diploid, we are having two copies of the same chromosome. That makes a homologous pair. So chromosome number 1 in two copies, chromosome number 2 in two copies, like that. Like that, we are having 22 pairs of homologous chromosomes plus X and Y. So let us zoom in this chromosome for better understanding. Suppose this is chromosome number 1. As you can see, this chromosome are having the same length, it is having the same centromeric region, it is having the same staining pattern, and also the position of genes on the chromosome, which is called as locus or loci, is the same. You can see here it is P gene, here also in this chromosome also there is P gene. Here also A gene, A gene. So here comes the allele. There may be slight version or different version of the same gene, which is called as allele. Here you can see there is capital C, here it is small c. Remember, both these codes for the same trait or the character. So as we all know, alleles are alternate forms of a gene. We are having two copies, one chromosome from the father and the other chromosome from the mother. So this makes a homologous pair. So this is the homologous chromosome. I would like to add one more point. Before replication, there is a single chromatid that makes a chromosome. After replication, that is in cell cycle, after S phase or synthetic phase, before meiosis or mitosis, we will be having a chromosome like this. Each chromosome with two chromatids that is held at the centromeric region. And these chromatids are called as sister chromatids. In meiosis, what is happening? The crossing over is happening between the non-sister chromatids of the homologous chromosome. These are homologous chromosomes, and the crossing over is happening between these violet and this green, that is the non-sister chromatids of the homologous chromosomes. Hope you are clear. Now moving into non-homologous chromosome. Non-homologous chromosomes are chromosomes that contain different genes, different staining pattern, and also therefore different centromeric location also. These chromosomes do not pair during meiosis. So let's take the same example, same karyotype. One chromosome of chromosome number 1 and one chromosome of chromosome number 2 homologous pair, that makes a non-homologous chromosome. Similarly, 10 and 11, 4 and 5, like that. Let's zoom in this chromosome. Suppose this is chromosome number 1 and this is chromosome number 2. So these are homologous pair. Chromosome number 1, this is having the same staining pattern, same centromeric region, it is having the same length. This is also having the same length, so everything is same in this case also. That makes chromosome number 2 homologous pair. Now these two chromosomes makes the non-homologous chromosome. As you can see, as per the definition, non-homologous chromosome contain different genes. Therefore, it will be having different staining patterns. And also the centromeric position is also different. So these chromosomes cannot pair during meiosis. And this makes non-homologous chromosome. Hope you got the point. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.